Hi everybody, this is Zohir Chaudhary, and we are reaching towards the end of our climate lecture module, and we'll talk about climate mitigation. So in general, there are two different strategies when it comes to dealing with climate change. We can try to stop future warming, which is mitigation of climate change, or we can find ways to live in our warming world, which is adaptation to climate change. Adaptation involves developing ways to protect people and places by reducing their vulnerability to climate impacts. For example, to protect against sea level rise and increased flooding, communities might build seawalls or relocate buildings to higher ground. On the other hand, mitigation involves attempts to slow the process of global climate change, usually by lowering the level of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. For example, planting trees that absorb carbon dioxide from the air and store it inside plant matter is an example of such strategy. Of course, there is another strategy, which is to do nothing. It is the triangle diagram in here sums these options. It is from the IPCC fourth assessment report. The corners of triangle represent 100% of each of these three options. Areas in the middle of the triangle represent a combination of approaches. There are costs associated with mitigation and adaptation. However, notice that with no action, we are facing a high cost associated with climate impacts because we'll be ill-prepared to deal with impacts. It's quite unlikely that we will be able to clean up the extra greenhouse gases and halt climate change entirely through mitigation efforts. Thus, some adaptation will be necessary. Both adaptation and mitigation are essential to reduce the impacts of climate change. Strategies to mitigate and adapt to climate change range from an individual to local, national, and global efforts. Adaptation happens in a variety of ways. Some adaptations are fueled by changes in government policies. Other adaptations occur because of technological advances. And there are, of course, ways that we individually adapt, insulating the attic to keep cool during summer heat waves, or raising the reinforcing, for example, raising and reinforcing a house in a hurricane-prone area. These are all individual adaptation measures. However, there are limits to how much we can adapt. There are often technological and financial limits that prevent the scale of adaptation that we would need. And often people are unwilling to change their behaviors. Plus, while humans may have the ability to adapt to climate change, many other species may not. In this slide, we are looking at the UNFCCC, which stands for United Nations Framework for Climate Change, and the Paris Agreement that the agency came up with, and the Kyoto Protocol. Many of you have heard about the Kyoto Protocol and the Paris Agreement. So the Kyoto Protocol was adopted in 1997 and entered into force in 2005. And the first commitment period was between 2008 and 2012. Now it is expired. The Paris Agreement was adopted in 2015 and was signed by 2016 and entered into force by late 2016. And what this does, essentially, under the Paris Agreement, there are two long-term goals and three cycles. The cycles are, as we mentioned earlier, a combination of mitigation, adaptation, and support, whereas the goals are to build global resilience and to phase out greenhouse gases to net zero. The one main objective of the Paris Agreement is to keep global temperature below the 2 degrees Celsius from pre-industrial level. As you may remember from the previous slide, lectures about how temperature rise leads to different health effects, the 2 degrees Celsius is a critical inflection point where we would have irreversible climate damage. So under the Paris Agreement, it is extremely important to keep global temperature below this level, preferably below 1.5. And as we mentioned, to start going to net zero greenhouse gases by increasing the by reducing the emission and then increasing the sink of the greenhouse gases. Under the Paris Agreement, mitigation and adaptation are now equal of importance. And as we mentioned earlier, we have global goals on adaptation and mitigation strategies. So some possible mitigation are listed in here. Because so much of the problem lies on the way we derive energy, so if we can slowly shift to renewable energy sources where there's no net greenhouse gas emissions, would be well ahead of mitigation. Some of the renewable energy sources are solar, biomass energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, as well as hydropower energy. In all of these cases, carbon dioxide emission or other greenhouse gas emissions, it's zero or close to zero or net zero. Net zero means that if carbon dioxide is created from the process of deriving energy, the process itself reabsorbs it so that the overall effect is net zero. Other mitigation approaches are out there as well. And one such very interesting approach is geoengineering. So geoengineering is the deliberate modification of Earth's environment on a large scale to suit human needs and promote habitability. And in here you can see some of the more important geoengineering approaches, and I'm going to talk of two to three of these interesting ones that seems to be maybe viable. However, it's subject to extreme criticism. So because carbon dioxide into the air is the main problem, the one possible way is to take that carbon dioxide, instead of putting it into the air, crystallize it or condense it and pump it into the soil or into the deeper part of the ocean. And as a result, carbon dioxide will be part of the soil and it would be embedded into the non-porous layer of the soil, impermeable layer of the soil, or because carbon dioxide is heavier as a liquid, it will stay on the bottom of the ocean. However, as probably you're thinking, there are many other problems associated with these proposals that it's beyond the scope of this lecture right now. Okay, so let's quickly do some concept check. Which of the following is a renewable energy source? That's correct. All of the above are renewable energy sources, E. Which of the following is or are proposed geoengineering approach or approaches to lower greenhouse gas concentrations in the Earth's atmosphere? That's correct. Two of the above, E, and the two that are correct is A and B, pumping liquid CO2 inside the Earth's crust and pump liquid CO2 deep in the ocean. All right, so that concludes our mitigation strategy, and